And welcome back here. We're getting ready to start the second half of play. Tippecanoe Valley leading here 38-16. And Seacrest and Sophie Buzzard lead Valley with 10 points apiece, followed by Meredith Broyette with 8. Valley will start off with the ball here to start the third quarter. And that'll go out of bounds on Plymouth. Boriette will inbound. Hannah Dunn for 2. That'll give Dunn 6 points on the night. Seacrest comes up with the ball. Boyette inside. That'll stay with Valley. Buzzard inside. She got it. That'll give Buzzard 12 points on the night. She leads Valley in scoring here for this game so far. Still plenty of ball left. 3-point attempt, no good. Seacrest comes up with it. That's going to be a travel call there on Dunn. That one no good. Seacrest with the rebound. But the ball will change possession. Addie Miller called for her second foul. Nice shot, no good there from Andrews. That'll be an over and back. That one no good. I believe Seacrest had a hand on that one. Dunn couldn't keep a hold of it. And it'll roll into the hands of the Pilgrims. Come on. Broyette call for her first foul. Loses the ball. And it'll go to Valley. Ball out of a timeout. So Valley leading here 42-16. Both of these teams beat Logansport. Valley beating them 94-24, almost a 100-point game for Valley. Plymouth beat Logansport 75-30. For three, and she'll get it. That'll give Broyette 11 points on the night. Valley now with three players in double digits and scoring. That shot off the front iron. Sechrist inside, she got it. She'll head to the line, try to make a three-point play here. Sechrist already 8 for 8 at the line for Valley. She'll try to go 9 of 9 to keep Valley at 100%, and she does. So Valley is still 100% on the free throw shooting. As they have a comfortable lead here, 48-16. Three-point attempt, no good. That three-point attempt, no good. That one will go out of bounds. And the Pilgrims will take a timeout here. And Sechrist is leading Valley here with 13 points, followed closely by Buzzard with 12, who's followed closely by Broyette with 11. So again, three players on the Valley squad in double digits as far as scoring goes. And again, Valley is 100% from the free throw line. Reichert scores there for Plymouth. C. Sechrist inside. Easy points there for her. And that'll give Sechrist 15. Sechrist got a hand on it. Broyette came up with it. She still got it. Buzzard inside. That'll give Buzzard 14. Three-point attempt. No good. Broyette for three. She hesitated a little bit. I think if she would have shot it on that first chance, I think she would have got it. Three-point attempt. That one is good. Number 22, Jenna Nifong for the Pilgrims. Sechrist shuffle passes it inside to Dunn. Buzzard will take it away there. Sechrist goes up. Oh, she couldn't get it. Jump ball. Emily Peterson and Olivia Tripedi coming back in for Valley. Still yet to see the court are Tanisha Brown and Mackenzie Woodcox. But I have a feeling we might see them here in the fourth quarter. Broyette for three, she got it. Broyette now has 12 points from beyond the arc, 14 in total. Another 3-point attempt, that one way off the mark. Peterson coming up with it. And one last shot, oh, almost had it. And at the end of three, Tippecanoe Valley leading here 57-21. Right now, Valley is 17 of 17 from the line. Pretty good stat right there. You don't see that many nights. And Sechrist has 15 points for Valley. Broyette with 14. I believe Buzzard has 14 as well. That she does. Looks like Asia O'Connor will be in now for Valley. That shot good there. Courtney Cook for the Pilgrims. That one taken away, and Cook is open there. Oh, she missed the layup. Gotta make those shots. And that one will go out of bounds. That one will not count. And Sechrist call for the foul. That's her second foul. Andrews for two. Oh, that one taken there. Andrews gets another two. Coach Kendig calls a timeout. Coach Kendig is not happy right now. Tippecanoe Valley is 1-0 in the TRC. And on December 17th, we're going to have a big matchup in South Whitley as Tippecanoe Valley will take on the undefeated Whitco Wildcats. That is a conference matchup. And I have a good gut feeling that one of those two teams will be the TRC champions this year, as Whitco is very competitive this year. So good matchup there on the 17th of December. Tripedi is in for Valley, almost lost the ball. Sechrist couldn't get a hold of that one. I think it was a bad pass though by Broyette. Two shot attempt is good. That one by Jenna Nafong. Sechrist, bad pass there. Coach Kendig calling another timeout, and he is not very happy right now. Valley with a 27-point lead here in the fourth quarter. Sechrist still leading Valley with 15 points, followed by Broyette and Buzzard with 14. Sechrist takes it. O'Connor inside, couldn't hold on to it. She'll head to the line. Valley is 17 of 17 at the line. O'Connor will be looking to improve it, and she does. So Valley still perfect from the stripe as she makes the second one. Well, that'll put Valley 19 of 19 from the line. So good night for Valley as a three-point attempt. No good off the back. Emily Peterson called for her first foul. Three-point attempt by Andrews. No good, stays in bounds, but it'll go to Valley. O'Connor inside, and she'll get it. Valley Valley now here with a 31-point lead as that one goes out of bounds. Addie Miller will check in for Valley. Poirier gonna take a breather. That one is gonna go out of bounds. Valley will keep the ball. Seacrest, that'll bounce in for her. That'll give Seacrest 17 points on the night. 9 of those points are from the line. That attempt no good. Miller for 3-0, in and out. Rebounded by Trapedi. She couldn't get in. And it'll stay with Valley. Peterson inbounds to Seacrest, who gives it to Miller. That was a 2 attempt. Stays inbounds. Another 3-point attempt. That one no good. Peterson call for his second foul. That shot no good, but there will be a foul on the play. O'Connor call for her third foul. And that one will go in. Cassidy Holiday for the Pilgrims. CeCe Robinson. Got my numbers mixed up there. Miller will be called for the travel. O'Connor gonna be called for her fourth foul. She'll have to be careful as they not get fouled out. CeCe Robinson at the line again for the Pilgrims. She misses the first one. She'll make the second. As Valley still leading here by 30. Pilgrims are all over Trapedi. Coach Kenda calls a timeout. Hannah Dunn will now be coming in for Valley. We still have yet to see Tanisha Brown or Mackenzie Woodcox, as they are the final two players on the bench for Valley. And Sechrist is leading Valley with 17 points, followed by Buzzard and Boyette with 14 apiece. Peterson set to inbound. That one stays in bounds. Valley still with the ball here. Allie Andrews called for the foul. Her fourth. She'll have to be careful for the Pilgrims. Of course, Valley done a good job this game in suppressing Andrews, as Sechrist will get two there. And that'll give Sechrist 19. And season high for a game is 20. So she might be looking to break her personal record there this season, as that one will go out of bounds. And Tanisha Brown will now come in for Valley. First time Brown seeing the court for tonight. O'Connor will come back in. And Dunn loses the ball. Asia O'Connor called for her fifth foul, and she'll be fouled out of the game. Boyette comes in for O'Connor. That shot no good. And I think it's safe to say that Valley's gonna walk away with the win here. Pilgrims tried to sail in here and claim this land for themselves. It's Brown, oh, couldn't get it. As I was saying, the Pilgrims tried to sail in here and claim Viking territory, but the Vikings hold their ground. And they will come out of here with a dominating win. Peterson with the ball. And she will go for two. That's Peterson's first points of the night. 3-point attempt, no good off the front bar. Dunn, I believe, calling for the foul. That's her second. First one no good there. Olivia Tripedi will come in for Valley. Second one no good. Rebounded by the Pilgrims. That'll be a kick ball. So Valley going to walk away with the win here, and they'll move to 6-2, as the Pilgrims will move to 6-2 as well. That shot no good, rebound no good. Hannah Dunn will pick up her third foul. Valley's next game will be on December 7th against Triton here at home. Ball up in the air. Little tussle for it. It'll go to the Valley. And Valley will just let the clock run here. So Valley gonna walk away with the win here as they win 67-34. And, well, that's the bottom line because the scoreboard says so. I'm Chris Sechrist, and you've been listening to an RTC Channel 4 presentation of Indiana High School basketball. Good night, folks.